Really good job.
Okay.
You got the honors for the title for both ones. Song number three. What do we got? Let's hear it.
Oh my gosh.
Do you want me to give you a hint?
Yes.
Okay, so this gal also was on a singing competition. And she's blonde. I'm really narrowing it down for you, aren't I?
Kelly Pickler?
Yes, that's right. Good job. Nicely done.
I forgot the name of the song, though. I know the song now that I remember.
Yes. Someone Somewhere. Is it Someone Somewhere Tonight? There you go. Yeah. Got it. I'm like, wait.
Tongue
someone,
twister.
It's a tongue twister. Okay. I mean, you are 3 for 3. You ready to get number 4?
I think so.
I think you're on a roll. Let's not stop it. Number 4, please. Let's hear it. Brothers hooked on Mary Jane. And daddy's hooked on Mary two doors down. Do you know this one?
Merry Go Round by Kacey Musgraves.
That's right. Why are you saying it so quietly? People always tell me, they're like, you have to be more confident when you say stuff. And I'm like, you know your stuff. Say it out loud. You are 4 for 4 plus extra bonus points. This t-shirt is looking like it's got your name written all over it.
Uh-oh.
Number 5. This one's kind of a trick. Oh, they're playing already. It's a little trick question. So, if you need a hint, I'll give you one. But why don't we play it again for her? You left your troubles in my head, in my head. You left your secrets in my bed, in my bed. So, it's a trick question because it's from a TV show. So, you can either guess the character or the person who sings it.
Is it from Nashville?
Yes, it is from Nashville.
Yes.
Do you know who sings it?
I know of that show, and I don't remember the names.
That's okay.
But it's the Hayden.
Yes, it's Hayden Panettiere. Yes. Good job. She plays Juliet Barnes, and that
yes.
song is awesome. I love
it. She's so cool.
Oh my gosh. I love this soundtrack. I don't know if you've ever listened to or watched the show, but it's so good. It's so good. All right. You got 8 points, I just told, in my ear. Thank God someone's doing the math. You get your t-shirt.
Yay.
So happy. You deserve that. I'm impressed with
your
country gal knowledge there. Okay, let's jump right into our fan questions right now. Now, like I said earlier, people literally have been sending questions for you like mad fire, like crazy, crazy, crazy. So what we had to do was we literally just picked the letter of the alphabet and picked those people's questions because there are so many. So we also did your favorites. So here are some of the questions about your favorite things. Okay, so starting with Jessica. Jessica wants to know, what is your favorite perfume to wear?
I love Katy Perry's Purr perfume. It smells so sweet and like cotton candy. It's amazing.
I second that notion. Okay, Jared, what is your favorite subject in school?
Ooh. I like doing like experiments. So like science, like physics is really hard, but
physics is so hard. So just stick with science. You don't have
science,
to go into great
that
detail.
Thing.
Okay. Jackie wants to know, what is your favorite thing to do during the winter?
Ooh. Winter and Christmas is my favorite holiday. So, I mean, I love just the whole atmosphere of the lights being up and the picking out the Christmas tree. And I love ice skating. It's really fun.
Can you ice skate?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm like, I just lay on the ground because I go nowhere. Okay, Jonathan wants to know, what is your favorite flower and why?
Huh, I never really thought about that.
I see it as like a sunflower, or like a daisy kind of girl. Or you like roses and like funky flowers?
I think the top would probably be the simple rose. Mm-hmm. Those are pretty anyway.
Yeah. They're, nice and simple.
The rose.
Okay, Jeannie asks, what is your all-time favorite dessert?
Ooh, this was actually in confessional on The Voice. I am addicted to cheesecake.
Oh, yum.
I mean,
thinking about cheesecake makes me happy.
Every chance I will eat. Like 24/7.
All right, we gotta take a break because I'm getting hungry. I need some cheesecake ASAP. But when we get back, we're gonna be talking to Danielle about her album. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Let's be real. There will come a time when robots control the planet. So until then, why let a computer control your music? At Music Choice, we know the best way to find you great music is to actually listen to it. That's why we have experts with ears who handpick the best songs to create music channels you'll love. No robots, no algorithms. It's your music and your choice. So why leave it up to numbers? MC, take back your music. We get it. Music is everything. You get your fashion, your style, and your dance moves from the artists you worship. So don't skimp where it matters. Turn to Music Choice Video On Demand and watch your music videos where they belong, on the biggest screen in the house. That's right, your television. There's a reason all your furniture is already pointing towards the TV, so put it to good use with Music Choice On Demand, the best way to get your favorite artists on the biggest screen. MC, take back your music.
Welcome back to UNA with me, Claire, and lovely Danielle. Still hanging out. Okay, so what was your first day like in the recording studio?
It was really fun. I kind of think of it as, like, before everything, I used to come home every day from school and go straight up to my room and sing for hours. Like, my mom would be like, oh, it's dinner time now, and I'm still singing at the top of my lungs.
She's still singing up there.
Yes, and I felt like the recording studio with the lights kind of down, and there's carpet sometimes, and I kind of pictured myself back in my room. And that was kind of like my comfort zone, and it was so much fun. And knowing that I was recording my own songs now, that was like the cherry on top.
Yeah, that's a huge deal. I'd be like, selfie, selfie. Yes. I've taken like a bazillion pictures.
I'm a selfie queen.
Yeah, me both, please, please. Okay, let's talk about the process of your album, okay? So you recorded it, fab. Now, how did you know which songs to choose for your album?
Well, they handed me about like two sets, like 30 songs maybe, and there was a lot to listen to, but it was really fun for me to listen to all of them. I was really interested and didn't complain about having all these songs. I'm like, ooh, what's next?
Yeah, you're like, ooh, it's like a whole choice.
Yes,
choice.
And I thought of the little things about if it came on the radio, what would people think, if they would keep it on the radio, if they would think of it as, oh, this sounds like everything else, like change and just those things I thought about, and like the words and if it would be appropriate for me to, I mean, showcase is my song, that's Danielle Bradbury's song, and I think the songs that I chose have their own personality, and they're all unique, and I mean, those powerful ballads I love, and there's just a little bit of everything, so it's awesome.
And The Heart of Dixie is your first, you know, stepping out
yes.
of the voice spotlight a little bit and being like, this is me, this is my music. So
yeah.
Why did you pick Heart of Dixie to be that song to reintroduce yourself to the world?
Well, that song got handed over to me, and the first time I heard it, it was automatically stuck in my head. It was so catchy, and I'm like, well, I mean, that's a good sign.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, hopefully they'll have the same effect on other people where they're just singing it around the house and it's just there. And it was something that I couldn't really relate to, of course, on the having a husband and that kind of story.
I was like, how are you related to someone having a husband? What are you talking about over here? I'm letting you get away with that one.
I kind of dug a little deeper and kind of thought of it, well, she's a girl that is having a rough time, but then she finds herself and goes on the right path, and she finds hope. And I thought, well, that's what really stuck out to me, and that's awesome. And maybe other people out there have had situations like that, and I'll be the storyteller for you. That's completely fine for me. And it was a really awesome song, and I'm like, okay, let it be my first single. That's awesome.
The music video was great. What was it like filming that?
That was awesome because I got to have my sister and my best friend in my music video.
Cool.
Yes, and it was a lot more comforting since it's all kind of our first time. And it was really cool because the director was like, y'all laugh, y'all talk about something, we want to get a shot of y'all laughing. And it was real, and it wasn't acting. It was with my best friend and my sister and everybody, and we were laughing and actually having a good time. And it just kind of left all the nerves behind. It was the first music video. It was just so much fun.
What was it like filming for The Heart of Dixie, the TV show? For those of you who didn't get a chance to see it, the show on the CW is The Heart of Dixie, and you sang Heart of Dixie on there. Like, that's like kind of crazy,
coincidence.
Right?
Coincidence.
Yeah.
I mean, my whole team and that whole team with their show, we just all kind of tonked.
Honky-tonk, whatever. You got some cute little accents, whatever you want.
They talked amongst themselves, and they were like, well, She has a single called Heart of Dixie. We have a show called Heart of Dixie.
Let's put it together. Perfect.
And it was a really awesome experience. I mean, I've been on a TV show, but I haven't been on a TV show where they're all acting and there's this whole little story going on. So I thought it was really awesome, and I got to guest as myself, which was cool, and sing my song, and it was so much fun.
Yeah, it was really cool.
Yeah.
So let's talk about, can you give me a little scoop on maybe your second single? Do you know what it's going to be, or have any idea for the music video?
I've been thinking about that a lot. We haven't really thought of one song that we're kind of tiptoeing around, but we're thinking about a couple, and I'm excited for it, and I'm excited. I mean, from the Heart of Dixie music video, I'm like, ooh, this would be an awesome video to do for this song, and I'm just excited.
Yeah, you're really excited.
I'm excited.
What's fast forward, whichever way you know. Go, I don't know. 2023, 10 years from now. Where do you see yourself music-wise?
Well, by that time, hopefully I'll be quite
driving.
Up there.
Driving. Okay.
Yeah, of course. But, I mean, the things that's been getting handed over to me, it's, like, amazing. And I'm just thankful for everything that just continues to get handed to me. And it's all such a crazy journey, but hopefully by that time I've always wanted to sing at the Houston Rodeo in my hometown, and that's kind of like, I want to get there. And just doing things like Taylor Swift, Carrie Underwood level.
I see it happening. So to your fans, let's bring it back to them right now. We have Dan on Twitter. He wants to know, what song did you sing for the executives in Dallas before the blind audition?
Ooh, I never got asked that question before.
I was going to say,
before.
I didn't That's even know awesome. That you had to do that, so I
there
liked that question.
Actually three auditions before the blind audition, off camera, and it was overwhelming. But for my first audition, when I first came to Dallas, I sang So Small by Carrie Underwood, and I made it past that, and I sang a couple of songs. It was Carrie Underwood. I sang a few of Miranda Lambert. And they actually asked me to sing Mean by Taylor Swift. And I'm like, oh, wow, this is crazy. I wasn't prepared, but I did it. And the audition after that was an executive audition in California. And I sang, they gave me Eyes Open by Taylor Swift from The Hunger Games, which I thought was the most awesome rock song. Yes, let's get into it. And it was awesome. And so those were the songs. And before I knew it, the Mean Taylor Swift is my blind audition song.
There you go. Perfect.
It all worked out.
It worked out very nicely. Okay, last one. I hate saying that. Last Twitter question. Here we go. What do you do on the bus to keep yourself entertained between shows?
I just kind of chill in the bus and just relax and try not to run around all over the place and get exhausted before my show. And I sit there, and my phone's my best friend, so I'm always on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. So even though I don't reply to people, I see everybody, and it's awesome. I see everything they say. It's crazy.
Well,
awesome.
Your fans love you. We love you here at Music Choice. Thank you so much for doing the show.
You're
such a pleasure.
You.
Thank you guys for sending in questions for Danielle. And make sure you get her album out right now. And taking us out is her music video for Heart of Dixie. We'll see you guys next time.
She had a dead-end job at the National Bank.